big, big hand, Mr. and Mrs. P. Subramaniam. This historic day in the life of MHS with the national... Principal designate, Mr. Paul Devadasan, to address us. Before that, we give you an opening song. Paul Devadasan to the rostrum. Mr. Paul Devadasan.
Istriya Asmi Subramaniam. Guru Guru, khasnya bekas Guru MHS. Dev-dev jabatan dan praja-praja sekalian. Bila tiba-tiba saya dipanggil, kemudian disusuli pula dengan iringan muzik I think you're very happy listening to music instead of listening to me. Walau bagaimanapun, saya terpaksa bercakap sedikit. Dan terlebih dahulu sebelum saya mengutarakan ucapan terima kasih khasnya kepada Tuan Pengetua dan isterinya, saya nak merakamkan setinggi-tinggi penghargaan khasnya kepada AJK, guru dan pelajar yang dalam masa suntuk telah menyediakan majlis perpisahan pada hari ini. I'm really very happy to see that within such a short time, our teachers and pupils have put up such a nice, fitting farewell ceremony. Biasanya dalam majlis perpisahan, kalau ada memahami maksud lagu tadi, hand in hand, dan juga terus dia, it gives us a feeling, a mixed feeling, satu perasaan bercampuran, yaitu perasaan gembira bahwa Tuan Pengetua kita akan bersara kali kedua. Kali pertama semasa beliau berkhidmat sebagai Pengetua Sekolah Menengah ISIS, dan kali ini pula sebagai Pengetua Sekolah Tinggi Methodist. Dan juga perasaan sedih kerana kita kehilangan seorang sahabat karib. I always considered him as my elder brother. And dalam majlis perpisahan seperti ini, biasanya benarkan saya menggunakan satu peribahasa. Biasanya disebutkan to meet, to know, and then to part is the saddest tale to the human heart. Walau bagaimanapun, saya tidak hendak meneruskan dengan suasana amat sedih, because God has blessed Mr. Maniam and Mrs. Maniam with a rich and a happy life. Jadi, perkhidmatan pendidikan, beliau telah mengambil keputusan untuk bersara. Thus far and no further. Cukuplah saya nak bersama-sama dengan keluarga saya. Semasa beliau keluar sebagai guru beri jasa kepujian dalam pertengahan tahun 50-an, at the end of 55, kalau saya tidak silap, saya baru meninggalkan masa persekolahan saya. Saya tahu sedar bahawa beliau adalah pelajar kanan di sekolah ISIS semasa saya di sekolah rendah. Tetapi perhubungan saya dengan beliau adalah rapat apabila saya balik semula sebagai pengetua di Perak dan bersama-sama beliau di beberapa persidangan, di beberapa mesyuarat dan terusnya. And it is indeed a great thing to know that Mr. Maniam, who obtained an honors degree in mathematics and physics, telah menukah fikirannya tanpa mencari gaji lumayan, dia terus masuk ke dalam bidang pendidikan. Sebab dalam pertengahan 50-an, kalau beliau telah hendak mencari jawatan tinggi, I think he was posted as education officer in Pahang, but he decided not to go there. He came back to ISIS. Dan sekian lama, tanpa menghiraukan sesuatu atau mengharapkan sesuatu yang istimewa, telah memberi khidmat bakti ke beberapa sekolah di mana beliau berkhidmat. I know a lot about him and I came to know more about him when we went out for lunch together. Hari-hari dari Jalan Linklifo, kereta mini minor, Old Faithful, datang tiap-tiap hari setelah pagi. Dan tak ingat istrinya, sehingga setelah petang, baru balik. I think Mrs. Maniam has tolerated Mr. Maniam for a very long time. And she also feels it's time you come back with me and spend more time with me. I mean, for 40 years, he has been all the while in the school. Demikianlah cara beliau telah beriman. Saya tidak hendak puji, memuji, tetapi khidmat bakti yang telah diberi oleh beliau tidak dapat diguraikan dalam perkataan seperti dalam majlis perpisahan ini. Kerana ini akan memakan masa yang banyak. Walau bagaimanapun khasnya bagi pihak diri saya, bagi pihak guru-guru dan pelajar-pelajar di sekolah MHS. Saya sedar dan tahu masa saya di persekolahan ACS, ACCS dimulakan dan mereka berkongsi dengan bangunan yang sama. Saya beriman pada masa itu masih aktif hari ini dan di Mr. Tarak Singh. He's still there. You should have seen Mr. Tarak Singh with his cane in 1946, 47, 48. Everybody will shiver. But he's still active. And I see him going after you. Still. Manuka namanya ke MHS. Dan sekian lama, Mr. Maniam had followed that philosophy of ACCS in MHS. Yaitu, Gereja Majlis ialah gereja yang pertama yang telah memberi peluang kedua kepada pelajar-pelajar yang gagal dalam peperiksaan. And MHS took them in, showed them the way to success. Dan falsafah itu dapat disimpulkan dan ditafsirkan melalui MHS. Why? In MHS, M, kita beri motivasi. We give you the motivation, even though you fail. There are many boys who have been thrown out of Subramaniam Putra and other schools. When their parents bring their children, Mr. Maniam always says, take them in. Itulah cara bagaimana beliau melayan murid-murid yang dianggap sebagai sekecil rendah hati untuk mengetahui Allah, but big enough to serve. Tetapi berbesar hati untuk memberi khidmat. And then H memberi harapan, hope to you. And S is success. Visionnya, misinya ialah untuk menjadikan sekolah ini sebagai sebuah maktab. Visinya akan menjadi kenyataan pada sekolah ini. So if at all you want to say thank you sir for all that you have done, what we can do is not to just say goodbye to him, but to show that we work hard as a team and bring success to me, kejayaan kepada sekolah ini. And that is how we say thank you to him. So we shall not say goodbye, we shall say so long to him. Because the gate is always open for him to come and taste the bitter coffee made by Mr. Jamit Singh. It's bitter, but not better. We hope that he'll make better coffee and entertain Mr. and Mrs. Maniam next time. And Mrs. Maniam, dia berasal dari sebuah keluarga yang music minded. Ma dia masih hidup, pernah menjadi tutor saya dalam choir semasa saya menyanyi. And she's still active. So, I started off saying to meet, to know, and then to part is the saddest tale to the human heart. But I ended up with a very light note. There was a piano tuner who turned up and told Mr. Maniam. Mr. Maniam said, I didn't call you. Yes, sir, but the neighbors called you because you have been playing the piano too often. Thank you very much.
Mr. Paul, they have an awesome father. We now have great pleasure to call upon the doyen of MHS Ipoh, Mr. Tarak Singh, to say a few words and give you a historical sketch of MHS Ipoh. Mr. Tarak Singh, a big, big hand for him.
Let me see. teachers, students, and special guests. It's a great honor for me to be given the privilege to speak at this assembly, at this special and memorable assembly. I've been asked to talk on the history of the school. The history of school is so remarkable and nearly 70 years old, I'm not able to do justice. But I will try my best to tell you what I can. Dr. L. Proctor, the principal of the ACS at that time, started the ACCS Ipoh for failures and overage students from the ACS. He started with two classes only. Later on, there was such a demand, the school began to grow and grow and grow. It became a very popular school. After Dr. Custer, the next principal was Mr. Percy Bell, a tall athletic personality. He set up a state record here. He was very cheerful. He used to go around the field to help the students in coaching. In 1936, Mr. Bell put up a science lab at the ACS, the first lab in Ipoh, and all the students of the ACCS were given the privilege to make use of the laboratory with all the facilities. Our school became very popular, so popular that many students came to our school, and more classes were added year by year. After Mr. Bell came Reverend Kasserling, a very humorous person, but very strict in work. He did well maintain the standard of the school. After that, in 1941, Mr. Wong Wai Lam was appointed the principal of the ACCS Ipoh, because it was too big a school. After 1941, the World War II came, and there was a break for some time. 1945, August or so, if I'm not mistaken, Mr. Wilder rushed back to the school to start again. This ACS field and the buildings were used by the Japanese army. They were all destroyed, upset, furniture gone, everything gone. He had a very difficult task to start the school. Also, no furniture, classrooms all damaged, field all damaged, and at that time it was very difficult to get British currency. People were very poor, and yet Mr. Wylam boldly started putting up the school. I joined the school as a member of the staff in 1946, and there were some others who joined. At that time, the school was completely without any funds. Mr. Wylam urged all the teachers to sacrifice and work for the good of the school. And you may laugh at me. Well, he did very well. The school prospered class after class, many. The school did very, very well. And enrollment went very high. At this time, I will speak a few words about the sports activities. The school was doing very well in sports activities. Very well. After that, I had used the afternoon classes to cater for the children. And then the problem came. Every year, two or three to buy a piece of land and I put up one building. He consulted the teachers and unfolded his plan. He knew that one day the school will be strangled out of existence. He was very brave to form that adventure. But And then he started collecting funds. He did a lot, went around. I was one of the members of the printing committee. And 1959, then he bought his land. He bought his land and put up the first building, main building, and hurried here, then known as the science block. And so on, the school began to grow. At the same time, the Methodist girls' afternoon school had the same problem. They were given this corner to put up a building put up by them. And the school came here. So here, the school was also doing very well. Mr. Yo Sinhua became the principal. He was a short, simple man, but very strict and fierce, very friendly, but made two achievements. One was, if I remember, he started the HSC classes of now we call Form 6 in 1968. Second, he also did his share. He put up this building known as the Wong Wai Lam Block. Well, after that, Mr. Sinhua retired in 1974. 1975 January, we saw that great giant coming here of the Methodist mission. Satish Ram. He came marching here, laughing, smiling, very cheerful. He came here, what wonderful things he did, I'm not able to mention. I remember one thing he used to say, the old order changes, yielding place to me. During the first teacher's meeting, this is what he said, I remember. I expect every teacher to do his duty and build up this school. I will do the administration. This Mr. Ram went too fast, too quick. Look here, look there, we know this, prepare this, everything doing something new. He changed the face of the school. He introduced many activities here. He introduced many things over here. He turned the school into another Asia. And many things he did. And Sini was aiming a lot. But it so happened, Mr. Ram got along with him his follower, very obedient and faithful follower. He was well groomed by him, by God's blessing. and then that follower, Mr. Jamit Singh. He became the next principal, waiting for the principal to come in. This Mr. Jamit Singh became tough and rough, boisterous, and he became very powerful. He did very well, kept up the school to the level of Mr. Ram. The only thing he didn't do or couldn't do was that as acting principal, he couldn't do any destruction or construction. So we waited for the next giant to come. In 1985, we saw another great notable figure coming to our school.